Colonel Fantock. Thus spoke the lady underneath the trees. I was a member of a family whose legend was of hunting. All the rare and unattainable brightness of the air. A race whose fabled skill in falconry was used on the small songbirds and a winged and blinded destiny. I think that only winged ones know the highest eyrie is so lonely. There in a land austere and elegant, the castle seemed an arabesque in music. We moved in an hallucination born of silence, which like music gave us lotus to eat, perfuming lips and our long eyelids as we trailed over the sad summer grass or sat beneath a smooth and mournful tree. And time passed suavely, imperceptibly. But Dagobert and Peregrine and I were children then. We walked like shy gazelles among the music of the thin flower bells. And life still held some promise, never ask of what, but life seemed less a stranger then than ever after in this cold existence. I always was a little outside life, and so the things we touch could comfort me. I loved the shy dreams we could hear and see, for I was like one dead, like a small ghost, a little cold air wandering and lost. All day within the straw-roofed arabesque of the towered castle and the sleepy gardens wandered we. Those delicate paladins, the waves, told us fantastic legends that we pondered. And the soft leaves were breasted like a dove, crooning old mournful tales of untrue love. When night came, sounding like the growth of trees, my great-grandmother bent to say good night, and the enchanted moonlight seemed transformed into the silvery tinkling of an old and gentle music box that played a tune of Circean enchantments and far seas. Her voice was lulling like the splash of these. When she had given me her goodnight kiss, there, in her lengthened shadow, I saw this old military ghost with mayfly whiskers. Poor harmless creature, blown by the cold wind, boasting of unseen, unreal victories to a harsh, unbelieving world unkind. For all the battles that this warrior fought were with cold poverty and helpless age. His spoils were shelters from the winter's rage. And so forever through his braggart voice, through all that martial trumpet sound, his soul wept with a little sound so pitiful, knowing that he is outside life forever, with no one that will ever warm or comfort him. He is not even dead, but death's buffoon on a bare stage, a shrunken pantaloon. His military banner never fell, nor his account of victories, the stories of old apocryphal misfortunes, glories which comforted his heart in later life when he was the Napoleon of the schoolroom, and all the victories he gained were over little boys who would not learn to spell. All day within the sweet and ancient gardens, he had my childish self for audience, whose body flat and strange, whose pale, straight hair made me appear as though I had been drowned. We all have the remote air of a legend. And Dagobert, my brother, whose large strength, great body, and grey beauty still reflect the Angevin dead kings from whom we spring, and sweet as the young, tender winds that stir in thickets when the earliest flower bells sing upon the boughs, was his just character. and Peregrine the youngest, with a naive, shy grace like a fawn's, whose slant eyes seem the warm green light beneath eternal boughs. His hair was like the fronds of feathers. Life in him was changing ever, springing fresh as the dark song of birds. The furry warmth and purring sound of fires was in his voice, which never failed to warm and comfort me. And there were haunted summers in Troy Park when all the stillness budded into leaves. We listened like Ophelia drowned in blonde and fluid hair beneath stag-antlered trees. Then in the ancient park, the country pleasant shadows fell as brown as any pheasant, and Colonel Fantock seemed like one of these. Sometimes for comfort in the castle kitchen he drowsed, where with a sweet and velvet lip the snapdragons within the fire of their red summer never tire. And Colonel Fantock liked our company. For us he wandered over each old lie, changing the flowering hawthorn full of bees into the silver helm of Hercules. For us defended Troy from the top stair outside the nursery when the calm full moon was like the sound within the growth of trees. But then came one cruel day in deepest June, when pink flowers seemed a sweet Mozartian tune, and Colonel Fantock pondered o'er a book. A gay voice, like a honeysuckle nook, so sweet, said, "It is Colonel Fantock's age which makes him babble." Blown by winter's rage, the poor old man then knew his creeping fate, the darkening shadow that would take his sight and hearing, and he thought of his saved pence, which scarce would rent a grave. That youthful voice was a dark bell which ever clanged too late. A creeping shadow that would steal from him even the little boys who would not spell. His only prisoners. On that June day, cold death had taken his first citadel.